Today I'll be installing the Pi Builder. That's our Microsoft Excel add-in that lets us edit Pi points and AF server objects in bulk. So the first thing I'm going to do is check for prerequisites. And I'll do that by going to the product section here on our tech support website. And the Pi Builder is actually part of our Pi AF client install kit, so it's going to be under the asset framework section here. And system requirements will be this tab. And scrolling down to Pi Builder, since I'm running Windows 7, we can see here that I meet that prerequisite. And since I have Microsoft Excel 2013 64-bit, I meet that prerequisite as well. So our installation should be successful. So we'll go ahead and download the kit. And like I said earlier, it's part of the Pi AF 2015 client install kit. So just make sure you download this particular asset framework client kit here if you're following along. So I'll go ahead and do that. And I'm going to save it to a folder where I can get it later. This is important because we have to right-click and run it as administrator. Alright, so after the installation, we'll just right-click on the install kit and run as administrator. The important thing about this is that it gives the install kit full access to the registry and all of the Excel system files. So we'll go ahead and click through this kit here. I'm going to install it to the default extraction path. That's fine for me. All right, so this is everything that gets installed with the AF client kit. But the most important thing is this Pi AF client 2015 R2. That's going to be where the Pi Builder is, so we'll just click OK here. Alright, so since this is the first piece of Pi software I've installed on this machine, it's going to ask me for my default servers, so we'll go and type those in right here. Oops. And the default install path is fine. Alright, so this is the AF part of the install kit. So we'll just make sure that our Pi Builder component is one of the features that are definitely going to be installed here. So it looks good, so I'll click Next. And again, we see here's the Pi Builder. So we'll click Install. So we can see here that the AF client 2015 component was installed successfully. So I actually need to restart my computer here because I didn't have this Microsoft Studio 2010 tools. So I'm going to go ahead and restart. And the final component of the install is just this setup wrapper. So we'll hit yes. And we can see here that the client was successfully installed. So we'll open up Excel and check the status of our Pi Builder. And now we can see that we've successfully installed our Pi Builder ribbon. So let's open it up and we can see here it is ready for us to use right away. Now, you may get to a scenario where you don't see the Pi Builder ribbon, and there might be a couple reasons for that. not only limited to after an install, but sometimes if you install a conflicting add-in, or if you log in as a different user, or if you install it without full admin rights, you might not get the ribbon. So a way to troubleshoot that is to check the Excel plugins. So we'll go into File, Options, and in Excel 2013, the add-ins are right here. And we can see the Pi AF Builder is listed here under Active Add-ins, and it's a COM add-in. So we'll go to our Manage COM add-ins and hit OK, or hit Go. And we can see there that the Pi AF Builder is checked. So for example, if this is not checked, the Pi Builder ribbon won't show up. So if you don't see the Pi Builder ribbon at all, just double check that you've activated the add-in under the COM add-in section and that check is there. So there it is after I've rechecked it. So this is a successful install of the Pi Builder. If you're following along the series, in the next couple videos we will edit some Pi points and then make bulk edits to our AF structure.